إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, plant today, harvest tomorrow. When I was asked by the brothers to come up with a theme for our conference this weekend, this is what came across. And when I initially thought about the theme, I was really addressing the new generation, our children, that if we do well planting that seed from the get-go, actually before you get married, by choosing the right spouse and by working hard and striving to instill in their hearts iman, faith, plant the tree of iman, the tree of faith in their hearts, the tree of la ilaha illallah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set a parable for us in the Quran, the verse in Surah Ibrahim, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةً أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Have you not seen how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set forth a parable for you? Here is the parable, a goodly word as a goodly tree. The goodly tree whose roots are firmly fixed in earth. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma says, Al-kalimatu at-tayyibah hiya la ilaha illallah. The goodly kalima is la ilaha illallah. وقال مجاهد الكلمة الطيبة هي الإيمان. The goodly word is الإيمان, that you plant in the hearts of the young ones. Then I was asked to come up with a verse for the theme. I recalled always, or I do recall always, the condition of Bani Israel in Egypt. How oppressed they were, how persecuted they were at the hands of the Pharaoh and his gang. And Bani Israel, for us, were the Muslims. The children of Israel, the followers of Musa at the time, were Muslims. They are our ancestors, not the Egyptians at the time. No, they are our ancestors. And this is what is meant by the verse, which is oft repeated in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا والنصارى والصابئين من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وعمل صالحا فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Indeed, those who believed, those who say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, والذين هادوا, and those who followed موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام at the time of Musa. Now the message is, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. If you truly a follower of Musa, and you're alive right now, you should say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, and consequently you accept Isa as well, because we know the Jews rejected Isa as well. So don't get confused with this. A lot of the Muslims, they come back, Shaykh, you say Christian and Jews are not going to Jannah. What about this verse? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَ وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. At their time, those who hadu at the time of Musa. The message at one stage was لا إله إلا الله, موسى رسول الله. The existing messenger of the time, you must follow that messenger. But now, if you're truly a follower of Musa, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, giving you the glad tiding of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and he told you to follow him. الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمية الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة. Those who follow the Nabi, the Rasul, the illiterate, the one whom they found written in the Torah, his description, wasfu yani. The Egyptians persecuted the Muslims. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to empower the children of Israel and restore justice in earth, look at the context of this, of the verse that I chose in Surah Al-Qasas. ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين ونمكن لهم في الأرض. And we want to grant our favor or bestow our favor upon those who were oppressed, the Muslims, Bani Israel. And we want to empower them in earth. وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَحْذَرُونَ. Look at the verse that I chose. Look at the context. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted this to happen. And we know that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted something to be, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us the system to change. Sunnat al-taghir. How can you make a change? Look. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. We reveal to the mother of Musa to breastfeed him, prepare him. Imagine this, ya ikhwa. I have to wait until Musa is born. And then he is thrown in the river. Picked up by the Pharaoh, brought up by his house. He spent so many years there and accidentally killing the Egyptian. And then he had to fled. He had to flee from Egypt, going to Midian. And then he married that woman in Midian. And he had to pay the dowry 10 years, shepherding for his father-in-law. And then in the way back, Allah calls upon him, now I want you to go and get the children of Israel out. Ya Allah. How many years are those? If you really count the number of years, we're talking about 40, 45, 50 years. If a plan today if you want to change the condition of the ummah, plan today and be patient. Change, ya ikhwa, takes time. And it does normally take time at the hands of the next generation. The best investment, the best contribution you and me can make to the Muslim ummah is these young ones sitting in the back. But there is something very interesting, and I want your attention for a second, because this is the cornerstone of my khutbah today. In the story of Musa, Musa alayhi salatu wassalam was nourished in Tawheed. Allah is the one who brought him up. Allah said in the Quran, وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي, so that you are made in front of me. But you had only 1, 2, 3, or just few individuals who are on the proper Tawheed. But the rest of his generation were not on Tawheed. Yeah, they were Muslims, like a lot of Muslims now. But the essence of Tawheed, the essence of La ilaha illallah, they did not possess it. What is my evidence? Why I'm saying this?
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ جَعَلَ فِيكُمْ أَنْبِيَاءَ وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا وَآتَاكُمْ مَا لَمْ يُؤْتِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Here is the first evidence. Allah commanded Prophet Musa alayhi salam to take the children of Israel to Palestine, to Palestine. Look.
يَا قَوْمِ دُخُلُوا الْأَرْضَ الْمُقَدَّسَةَ الَّتِي كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ.
Oh my people, enter this holy land that Allah ordained upon you at this time. مش forever, at this time. What did they say? No, we're not going to do it.
قالوا يا موسى إن فيها قوما جبارين.
Out there are people of excessive. They were giants, huge.
وإنا لن ندخلها حتى يخرجوا منها.
And we're not going to enter it unless they leave it. In some of the wording of explaining this verse in Surah Al-Ma'idah, that Joshua, Yosha ibn Nun, is the one who actually given them the nasiha that عَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلُوا رِلَايَبٌ Allah. Look at the response.
قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى إِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا أَبَدًا.
Oh Musa, we will never enter it. مَا دَامُوا فِيهَا. آخر كلام كده. As long as they are there. شوف الكلام.
فاذهب أنت وربك فقاتل.
Go you and your Lord, fight, and we'll wait for you here. وَإِنَّا هَا هُنَا قَاعِدُونَ. فما كانوا على التوحيد. They were not on Tawheed. They did not possess. So planting the seed of Tawheed in so many is what is needed. You see, the work of Islam is not to be done on the shoulder of one person, even if he is the messenger of Allah. It's a collective work. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Surah Al-Anfal, and he is telling him, هو الذي أيدك بنصره وبالمؤمنين وألف بين قلوبهم لو أنفقت ما في الأرض جميعا ما ألفت بين قلوبهم ولكن الله ألف بينهم. Allah is the one who supported you, O Muhammad, with his victory, because normally victory comes from Allah and at the hands of the believers around you, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, رضي الله عن الجميع. The just to show you another evidence. Another evidence regarding the quality of Tawheed that the followers of Musa at his time possessed. And I'm really bringing it up to show you the quality of Tawheed that the Muslims have now. And I'll tell you, I'll go back to the children of Israel, but I will narrate what relates to us. Hadith Abi Waqid al-Laythi radiyallahu anhu fi Sunan al-Imam al-Nasa'i. After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered Mecca, conquered Mecca, after he was expelled, and they fought him three major battles, Badr, Uhud, Al-Khandaq, and more. Then he came back conquering. When he arrived, a lot of the people who were living in Mecca, especially the leaders, they accepted Islam. But again, remember, they were not nourished in Tawheed. They did not learn La ilaha illallah. Remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam spent 13 years teaching La ilaha illallah. Teaching just La ilaha illallah. Makathna 13 sinin fi Mecca. La ilaha illallah. Who is Allah, Jannah, and Hill. For those individuals who never sat in a circle of learning, the head of it is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never learned Tawheed. For Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took them on a battle of Al-Ta'if. For they had to camp at night. For somehow the camp of the disbelievers, the other army, Al-Ta'if, they could see them. And they had a tree. They used to call it Dhatu Anwat. كانوا يتبركون بها. They used to seek blessing out of that tree, and they used to hang their swords on it. And they go around it. Not the Sahaba, not Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, they will never make that statement. Not those who were nourished in Tawheed, because sometimes some people with wicked hearts, they take that hadith out of context. So those newly revert, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said to him, Ya Rasulullah, اجعل لنا ذات أنواط كما لهم ذات أنواط. Can we have a tree like them, O Messenger of Allah, please? Huh? Can we have a turkey, please, for Thanksgiving? I'm a Muslim. It's going to be halal and dabiha. Can I have a turkey? Can I have a Christmas tree, please? Can I have a Christmas? Look the magnitude. Because, listen, if you do not take pride of who you are in what your religion is, and you go and take pride in other people's holidays, listen, I'm not calling you to disrespect our neighbors. We never do this. Respect them, honor them. But respecting them, that does not mean that you go and do like them. Huh? Look what the Prophet ﷺ, and that's why I narrated the whole thing. Look what the Prophet ﷺ said to the Muslims at the time. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! قُلْتُمْ كَمَا قَالَ بَنُوا إِسْرَائِيلَ لِمُوسَى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آله. He said exactly like those who were not nourished in Tawheed, the followers of Musa. He said exactly like them. What happened? Look at the verses, the context of the statement of Bani Israel, which the Prophet is referring to. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saving Musa alayhi salatu wa salam and Bani Israel from the Pharaoh, in front of their eyes, that sea turned to be a bridge. وَإِذْ فَرَقْنَا. فَرَقْنَا, you know what فَرَقْنَا is? فَرَقْنَا, divided. We told the water to stop. Imagine the stream of water. فَرَقْنَا بِكُمُ الْبَحْرِ. Like this, cross, go ahead and cross. وبعدين, at the beginning, Musa is telling them, إِنَّ مَعِي, this is from Allah. قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. Oh Musa, the Pharaoh and his army are gonna kill us. قَالَ كَلَّا. No, إِنَّ مَعِي يَا رَبِّي. كُلْ, all of what will happen from Allah. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى أَنْ اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرَ فَانْفَلَقْ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Cross. طيب, The Pharaoh with his dumbness thought that this can work for him too. He took his army into the sea. Allah commanded the water to go back to its normal course. He drowned in front of you. تبشوف. Look what the Prophet is referring to here. وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرِ. As soon as they crossed the sea and they just saw this miracle.
فَأَتَوْا عَلَىٰ قَوْمِي يَعْكُفُونَ عَلَىٰ أَصْنَامٍ لَهُمْ.
They saw some Bedouin in Sinai worshipping an idol. Worshipping an idol.
قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى اجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهَةً.
Oh Musa, can we have an idol like them, please? Oh Musa, can we have a Christ? I'm a Muslim, but can I have a halal dhabiha? Halal dhabiha turkey for Thanksgiving? It's okay. Can I be like them, please? وصم بس يقول له, go ahead, be like them, يا أخوي. تفضل يا سيدي. كل, eat. We're talking about a generation here. I don't want to prolong this, but you know the wisdom, the ultimate. I mean, you have to really give them the excuse too. You have to give Bani Israel the benefit of the doubt. Why? Because they were living in an environment of shirk all their lives. They actually used to build these idols for the Pharaoh. Mahawa tells you that if there is a wicked environment, don't live in it. Otherwise, it will get to you. Mahawa, you have to give the children of Israel the benefit of the doubt. Mahawa, why when we find ourselves in a place where evil is committed, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you what? Man ra'a munkaran, you see it, change it. Hand, force the change. What if there are bad consequences? Negative, assess the negative and the positive consequences. Hisab al-masalih wal-mafasid. Then use the tongue, da'wah, sweet words. But what this doesn't, if it doesn't work? The heart. But something goes with the heart. Build a wall. You can't be in the vicinity of evil. Now the heart actually is the most difficult. People think the heart, oh, I'm going to stay around people who drink, and my heart is denying that. Ya Habibi, your heart is going to drink it in a day or two. Mahawa, what happened to Bani Israel? They are living in that environment. People are bowing down to the Pharaoh and building these idols. For them, they lost the sense of Tawheed. That this is actually a violation of Tawheed. Give them the benefit of the doubt. I'll give you a good example, but I know it's disgusting to some of you, but it really serves the point. You know, I come from Egypt and I live in the east side, and normally when I go from Cairo airport to my village, there is a running stream of human sewage. I'm sorry, I'm going to discuss to you for a second, but it's really going to get my point across to you. Called Bahr al-Ba'r, they call it. When you cross over that bridge, you're almost going to vomit because you can't take the smell. But then after I cross, I see actually people living at the banks of that. They are actually living, having homes. And my brothers tell me actually the land here is more expensive than any other land. And you probably know why now, because of the produce. Let's not get into details here. Huh? And then what about those people? How can they take that smell? They said 3 days. They don't smell it. A smoker doesn't smell a smoke. If you smoke, you're not going to smell. But if you do not smoke, when somebody who smokes come near you, man, brother, please. But if you're a smoker, we're together. That's what happened to Bani Israel. They got contaminated. They got... بس شوف the divine wisdom of Allah that لا إله إلا الله benefits. Shuf, look at the divine wisdom of Allah. That generation, even though they possessed Tawheed, they said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, but their Tawheed is not strong enough to get the work of Allah done. Therefore, they have to be replaced. But in a wise course, what happened? وَوَعَدْنَا مُوسَى أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً. Musa had appointment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 30 nights, and then he completed 40. Allah sent to them a summary. You know what? Musa is no longer here. He's not going to come back. And he collected this gold that they stole out of Egypt, and he turned it into a calf for them. Let's worship that calf. So he ended up worshiping the calf. Musa alayhi salam comes back. What was the expiation for that sin? Imagine this. And this is one of the blessings of Tawheed, our Tawheed, that even if you violate the essence of Tawheed, all what you have to say is La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, you're back in the fold of Islam. But look at Bani Israel. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ إِنَّكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ بِاتِّخَاذِكُمُ الْعِجْلِ. You wronged yourselves taking the calf as a god. طيب, what are we going to do, يا موسى؟ فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ فَاقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. The expiation for that sin, that you kill one another. There is a divine wisdom. If they die this way, they repented, they would go to Jannah. And there is another one. Then that generation is over. That weak generation, that feeble Tawheed, that sick Tawheed is over. Then Yusha Abdu Nun, Al-Fata, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِفَتَاهُ. Joshua is to lead the children of Israel into the promised land, the next generation. Musa was one person is not sufficient, two are not sufficient, four are not sufficient. We do have, alhamdulillah, in the ummah, people who have tawheed, but we're outnumbered. يقول لك اتسع الخرق على الراقة. You know, trying to sew here, sew here, sew here, and you see a hole here, hole here, here. صعب. متى يبلغ البنيان يوما تمامه إذا كنت تبني وغيرك يهدم. أنت شغال, you're working here, and other people are working with their books, horns, media, all type of things. وأنت one person. The solution is what? Is to nourish and bring a new generation on Tawheed. That value, that kalima, that know the essence of that kalima, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله, صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين, وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, لنا باب في ديننا يقال له سد الذريعة. We have a chapter or a whole section in our religion is called سد الذريعة. What do we mean by سد الذريعة? That there is an act, you could do it, but the Sharia tells you don't do it because it will lead to a greater evil, or it will take you to a sin. Blocking the way to a greater evil. Sometimes the scholars, they learn the preciousness of a command or the preciousness of a prohibition from that window. It's a little bit academic, but pay attention here. Tawheed is the most important thing. La ilaha illallah is the most important thing. Let's look into some of these things which we were not, or we were banned from doing because it will lead to a greater evil, which is shirk. To show you the preciousness of Tawheed. One of them is exaggerating regarding the status of a creating being, a created being, human being. ولذلك علماء التربية, the scholars of تربية, they say من أوسع أودية الباطل الغلو في الأفاضل. One of the greatest gates to committing shirk, falsehood, that you exaggerate regarding the status of a human being who is honored. And this is what our neighbors, our co-workers fall into. They exaggerated regarding the status of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Christians at the time of Isa, immediate time, they never even uttered the word son. If you actually ask an old Christian, someone who has been here for 100 years, he tells you that that Father, Son, Holy Ghost thing is a new thing. That Jesus is the Lord is a new thing. Yani to them, yeah. But how they got into trouble? Exaggerating regarding the status of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. ولذلك الغلو, this is what we call غلو. ولذلك, look at this, لفظ الغلو, the word غلو, exaggeration, was mentioned in the Quran twice, and both of them with regard to Prophet Isa alayhi salam. The first one, يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله. O people of the book, do not exaggerate in your religion and don't say anything about Allah except the truth. Indeed, عيسى بن مريم رسول الله. And I know you know these words. وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله انتهوا خيرا لكم ولا تقولوا ثلاثة إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا. ده سورة النساء. Look at the second place. Look at the second place. في سورة المائدة. But really, before you grasp the meaning of this one, read the verses before it. ما المسيح ابن مريم إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل وأمه صديقة كان يأكلان الطعام. Indeed, the Messiah ibn Maryam is a messenger who came in a chain of messengers, and his mother is a truthful woman. Look at this, look at this. They used to eat food. That means they need. The God cannot need. من اسم من أسماء الله الغني, the all sufficient. We need him, he does not need us, subhanah. And then the verse comes, look at this. قل يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم غير الحق. So what the Christians fall into? Exaggeration regarding the status of Prophet Isa alayhi salam, even though, be careful, Prophet Isa is innocent of this. Comes in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is telling us Muslims, listen, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم ولكن قولوا عبد الله ورسوله. Don't ever praise me like the Christians praised Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. But say what? عبدالله ورسوله. Why? Because this opens the door to what? Making me equal to Allah. One day, في سنن الترمذي, حديث ابن عباس, imagine a companion says to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن شاء الله وشئت. If Allah wills and you, he said, never say that. Never say that. لأن الواو حرف العطف, and in Arabic makes what comes before it and what comes after it equal. Equal in everything. وأحمد ومحمد, أحمد and محمد are equal. No, rather say إن شاء الله ثم. ثم, then I will. So my will as a created being comes under the will of Al-Alim, Al-Khabir, Al-Hakim. ودخل عليه رجل كما جاء في مسند أحمد حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أنت سيدنا وابن سيدنا وخيرنا وابن خيرنا قولوا بقولكم. Say as you please. I don't like that. إنما أنا عبد الله. You see, سد الذريعة, that you pray. Right now, الشيخ الفلاني, يا الله الشيخ, ده بيقول لك مش عارف ايه عمل. Why Muslims now are worshipping graves? Righteous people. Righteous. They could be righteous, by the way. Wallahi, a lot of them are righteous and pious. But ضعف التوحيد, the weakness of tawheed in their hearts. ولذلك, if you're really righteous and you're still alive, you should not allow even the person in front of you takes a wrong idea about you. يعني حديث المغيرة بن شعبة والحديث في البخاري ومسلم, that the sun eclipsed, and that eclipsing happened, خسفت يعني, خسفت الشمس, that eclipsing happened on the same day on which Ibrahim, the son of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, passed away. فقال الناس, look, the Muslim said what? لقد خسفت الشمس لموت إبراهيم. وده حاجات من الجاهلية. They're calling it from جاهلية. The sun eclipsed because of the death of Ibrahim. قام رسول الله فيهم. Look, this is the job. The job of the messenger or the job of a student of knowledge. That you never leave any ground in the minds of your followers that you have any more attribute than a human attribute, that you're not divine. He stood up and he said, إِنَّ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرِ آيَاتَانِ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ لَا يُخْسَفَانِ لِمَوْتِ أَحَدٍ أَوْ حَيَاتِهِ فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُمَا فَافْزَعُوا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَفِي لَفْظِ الصَّلَاةِ وَفِي لَفْظِ الدُّعَاءِ وَفِي لَفْظِ الصَّدَقَةِ. The sun doesn't eclipse because of, this is ayah. When you see the eclipsing, then we have a salah called Salatul Al-Khusuf. One day, inshallah, we'll be done here in a minute. One day, just keep coming. Hadith Anas for Sahihain, a Bedouin, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is in the pulpit like this, but he really have to visualize that the masjid of the Prophet did not have these nice ceilings. It's straw, so if it would rain, the water would come through. فدخل بدوي, a Bedouin enter into the masjid. Imagine this. Ya Rasulallah, halaka al-dar'u wal-zar'. The animals are dying, the vegetation are dying, no rain. Ud'u Allah, ask Allah to bring down rain. Da'a. Wa al-minbar ya ikhwa, on the pulpit. Al-khatib idha da'a bis-sababa. Min al-bid'a an yarfa' al-khatiba yadayhi. Hakadha. Min al-bid'a bis-sababa. Da'a. Anzil al-ma' ya Rabb. Du'a. Shuf. Rawi al-Hadith Anas ibn Malik said, Wallahi, Rasulullah did not come down from the pulpit until the water poured out of the masjid. Nazal al-Matr. And guess what? Stayed raining for a whole Jumu'ah. Jumu'ah meaning week. The following Jumu'ah, the same Bedouin entered the masjid while the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is delivering the khutbah. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, هلك الزرع والدرع. The animals are dying because too much water. Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did like this. Allahumma hawalayna wala alayna. Oh Allah, around us. They said, they looked at the sky as if it did what the Prophet. This can invite you to think that Rasulullah is divine. Then he looks at his companions. Ashhad, I bear witness, inni abdullah, I am the slave of Allah. This is protection of Tawheed. Protection of Tawheed. يقول لك الشيخ الفلاني ده, يا الله لو رحت له, he is gonna know the unseen for you. And he will do. لا, protection of Tawheed. We have to teach our children, brothers and sisters in Islam, to protect that Tawheed. And the way that you protect it is by understanding it fully, properly, that no one is worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm telling you, wallahi ya ikhwa, the best who can understand Tawheed are the children. In 1 minute, I sat in front of the Sunday school kids. I think I was in Windsor, Connecticut that weekend. Wallahi ya ikhwa, I challenged myself and I said, I want these children to understand what La ilaha illallah means. That's it. I have a half hour. My mission is to make them understand La ilaha. And I'm talking about kids that you have to tell them sometimes, hey, be silent. Hey, stop. Come on. Stop jumping. Please don't talk without. You're still going to be interrupted. Not like you sitting, mashallah, and giving me the attention. Huh? You still have to deal with that discipline. Shuf. I told them, La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. Ala al-haqiqa. I asked them first, what La ilaha illallah means? They said, there is no God except Allah. I told them this is wrong. Because if you look into the world, there are other gods. The people worship Jesus, he's a God. People worship the Son, he's a God. So that statement, there is no other gods but Allah, is wrong. Because there are other gods and there are other people who worship other gods. But what you should say, La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah. But no one deserves the worship and the submission and the obedience except Allah. Why? Because He is the Lord. He is the one who created me. Any other God created you? They say no. Who provides for you? Allah. This is where, that's why the scholars of Tawheed of Aqidah call like, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. يوجب توحيد الألوهية. The توحيد of الرب, the fact that you believe that Allah is the Lord, the creator, the sustainer, the provider, the one who giving you the life that you have, the one who's going to decree death upon you, this necessitate that you only worship Him. Why do you go and worship others? Why? الله الذي خلقكم. Allah is the one who created you. ثم رزقكم. Then He provided for you. ثم يميتكم. Then He will cause death upon you. ثم يحييكم. Then He will resurrect you again. هل من شركائكم من يفعل من ذلكم من شيء. Any other idol, any other rival can do this? The answer is no. فلا معبود بحق إلا الله. And He kept giving them examples. They understood it. So this is the mission of the conference this weekend, inshallah, planting that seed, La ilaha illallah, in the hearts of as many young ones as possible. Because I'm telling you, don't sit out there and say Al-Mahdi is coming and he's going to take care of the world. La ya habibi, Al-Mahdi is not going to do things on his own. Al-Mahdi needs helpers. He needs you and me. He needs you and me to correct the condition of this ummah. That is why we have to keep investing in our children. Brothers and sisters in Islam, plant today your harvest tomorrow. Inshallah, if we keep planting more good seeds that understands the value and the preciousness of La ilaha illallah, inshallah the ummah will harvest tomorrow. The condition of the ummah will be better bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And this is the purpose and the goal of this conference this weekend. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna itiba'a wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinaba. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min al-fitan ma zahara minha wa ma batan. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اصلح شباب المسلمين. اللهم اصلح شباب المسلمين. اللهم نشئ أولادنا وبناتنا يا رب العالمين نشأة حسنة يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أنبتهم نباتا حسنا يا رب العالمين كما أنبت مريم يا أكرم الأكرمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.